car on the entry. Then up to Union Mills. Driving down through Union Mills. Close wall by the side makes it seem a lot quicker. Passing through the 3 mile marker. Up the hill and then down to one time.
big left.
On towards Douglas Road. Braking hard and down to the gears. Passing the mitre into Kurt Michael. This is what makes the Alpha special point. Flat out. Passing the 15-mile mark on the exit. Favourite spot for many riders. It can get quite slippery through here. A fast left-right exit through 16 miles. A fast right-hander. Miles down through the gears. Not worth doing a big job, too much risk of damage. Past Glen and on towards Balakran. Very fast bend indeed. A big jump out of this one just before Quarry Bends. On the small bike, you go flat out through the first right-hander. Halfway around the course. At the 19-mile mark. So be straight, it's just like a green tunnel at those speeds. Miles. Very tight right-hander. And the power piles on again here. The slow, slumpy bridge corner. Up over the top towards Carrow Moor. Now a very bumpy section all the way to Ramford. On the footrests all the way through here. It's so bumpy. Over the jump, on the exit, for Glendon. Just past the 21-mile marker. On the brakes approaching Glen Tramon. You're a right-hander with severe adverse camber. That's 1 to 2 miles. A bumpy right-hander into your old town. To Ramsey. It's amazing how slow Parliament Square is. Really bumpy on the way out of this one. A sweeping right-hander. Past 24 miles. towards the hairpin now. Another second gear corner. A real short circuit corner. Just before the hairpin, first gear into this. It's really easy to fall off and make yourself look silly here. It's all uphill from here. This is the start of the mountain section. At the 25-mile marker. Tight rising right-hander. Good line through all these fast corners. Named after Jimmy Guthrie, the spot of his retirement in the 37th Senior TT. After this, you try to get your head down for the mountain mile. There are 27 miles around the course. Flat out from top gear along here. This is where the fog comes down. First real chance to relax a bit, and still be quite a long section. Keep tucked in, as tight as you can along here. It's supposed to be a straight, but at 180 miles an hour, those slight bends become a lot bigger. Passing the 28 mile mark. Passing the 3/4 way post. Sometimes known as the East Mountain Gate. Just past the 29 mile mark. There's a fair dip going past the hut. Long left approaching the veranda. You take these four right-handers as one if you get it right. Then the 30-mile mark. You treat this one with a lot of caution. Not many circuits have tram lines across them, under the footbridge, but hard on the gas. The highest part of the circuit. From here on, it's downhill almost all the way home. Back a few gears into Brandywell. Fast left-hander. Just before the 32-mile mark. The 32 mile mark. So you grab the trap there if you get into trouble. A really fast approach to the 33rd. A really fast double left hander. Breaking through the right-hander into the Keppel left-hander. Top left-hander. Down towards the steep hill. Down towards the crag. At the 34-mile point. Hard on the brakes into the crag. Easy corner to make a silly mistake on. probably the fastest part of the course. Just before heartbreaking into Brandish. Down a few into this one. A left-hander at the bottom of that fast section. And accelerating hard off of this one. Fast right-hand exit. At 36 miles. A multiple left-hander. You have to watch for the dip on the exit of this one. Second gear round here. A very slow tight bend. Then dive down the hill through Bedstead. Quite a tricky corner. Give it just a bit of gas down towards the nook. Down lots of gears. Tightest and slowest bend on the course. Really get the power on after this. Onto the start finish line. Back down West Country Road. Screaming down here if you want a flying lap.